that it will result in us having the comfort to be able to engage in a mockumentary. And I do not believe that it gives us the foundation of saying, well, we're going to use this one standard in mocking the Islamic sources, when we know that if that, let's say a person leaves Islam because of this, let's say even somehow they're graciously brought into the church, but then in many situations, they still have to engage with Islam because of family situations or the context in which they live. And now someone who is trained, as many people in Islam are, to do da'wah, the da'i come, and they start pointing out the inconsistencies and the double standards that were used in the original mockery of the Islamic sources. And this is, again, here's this whole thing I said before, the consistency thing. Now you're having to, on the one hand, say, well, we need to contextualize these things. You need to listen to the best of what we have. And here's, you know, here's responses based upon looking at what the context and the time was and what the religious beliefs of the day were. And this is the background of this part of the law that seems so out of place today. And this is the background of that part of the law. And we have to start doing all those things. And we didn't give that freedom in our mockumentary. And so now we're using a double standard. And this, to me, is highly problematic, because